Tell us what you've been doing since the last time you were on my project. Now, this is like our sixth or seventh show with the music.
Yeah.
And you got an album that you put out that's on, is it SoundCloud? Is it on SoundCloud?
Oh, wait. Oh, man. It's on Spotify. It's on iTunes. It's on Apple Music. It's on SoundCloud, of course, Reverb Nation. So I made it available to, so, you know, can't nobody miss it, you know. And
yeah,
so I,
right.
You know, I put all these singles together, and I told you I was going to create one big project, you
yes,
know, dedicated
yes.
to your show, because it was your platform, and you bringing me on this platform to be able to introduce my style of soul music, my style
yes.
of spiritual music. And so that's what I came up with. That's exactly what I came up with. And so
okay.
it's out there now, so nobody can't miss it anywhere.
Yeah, they can't say they ain't heard it.
But nah,
you got
man,
it
nah.
on all platforms. Can you go ahead and mention the name of the album?
Well, the name of the album, the project's going to be called, right now at this point, it's called Soul Brother Number 1970.
Yeah,
I came up with that. I came
yeah.
up with that concept. I said, because, you
I
know, Soul Brother Number 1970. And so people ask me, why you call it Soul Brother Number 1970? It's because simply we know James Brown.
Yeah.
You know, he's Soul Brother Number One without a doubt, right? So
yeah.
I'm like, well, who's number two? Curtis Mayfield or is it Black Moses, Isaac Hayes? You know, so
yeah.
you know, is he number three? Then you got Earth, Wind, and Fire. You got Luther Vandross. You got Peabo Bryson, James Ingram. I said, well, you know what, man? I can't even figure out which soul brother I'm at, so I'm just going to use my 1970. That's my birthday. So,
right.
My birth year, so I just came with Soul Brother Number 1970. And so that's why I pretty much groove the way I do with my brand of spiritual music. And so I wanted to come up with something unique, of course. And so that's pretty much what I came up with on that.
Well, you have a lot of fans and followers that are catching up and really digging your groove. They love your vibe. And let's talk about this one song here that I fell in love before it hit the charts.
You remind me of a quiet storm, so smooth and warm. You soothe my soul, my heart you hold.
That's this jam right here. Love
yeah.
you.
Now,
yeah, it's still running up the chart, right?
It is. It's number one. It's actually number one on numberonemusic.com. Oh, yeah. Man, it's really moving. I'm getting a lot of response, a lot of comments from Australia, the UK, from Sweden, all these people commenting. To numberonemusic.com, how much they love this song.
Yes.
You know, it's just, I didn't think the song was going to, you know, I mean, I was feeling it when I did it, but I had no idea, but it's slamming.
I was so excited because when I played it on the show, I got feedback on SoundCloud because, you know, my shows are everywhere online to be
yes.
listened to, and everyone loves that song. And they were sending me the feedback. And I was trying to tell you, look, Lee, look. All I could do is like, look what's going on. Your baby is getting up there. Your baby's growing.
Yeah, man.
It's exciting. It is so much exciting. I am so glad I'm in your world because I'm so happy for you. And so tonight we're playing new music that you have. So I like to ask you, what other surprises you got in for that you could let us, you know?
Well, you know what?
You got something up your sleeve now, don't you?
Yeah, man. I'm getting ready to go in another direction as well. I just got off the phone a little bit ago. Had a conference call with an alternative rock band. We're going to fuse some soul We're going to infuse some jazz with them, and some things rolling around in my head to do with them. And so they're very excited about that. I've been talking to these fellas for the past maybe 3 months now. And so we finally connected. So I'm bringing them aboard my my production company, so that way I could work with them and pour into them. And of course, I'm trying to get Henry Jones III, his project. I'm trying to get that finished. He's a guy that does all my vines for me, creates all my vines. And so I'm excited about that as well. So that's what I'm working on right now. Shiya. Okay. I sent her some stuff a while back, so I'm waiting on the call for that when she's ready. So it's some other folks that are, as a matter of fact, a brother out of Chicago. That's one of the cities, as a matter of fact, that followed me real strong on numbermusic.com as well.
Yeah.
And on your show. Yeah, it was a brother that reached out to me, John Bailey. We've been talking and everything, and remember, he was a soul brother as well, so he and I are going to be collaborating on some things together coming up.
Well, you mentioned John Bailey. He's another next upcoming guest on my platform coming up.
Solid, man. That's solid.
I've been trying to keep in touch with him, and so, be looking forward to John Bailey being on my show soon. Yeah, so everybody get a taste of the music that he has sent me, and then they'll be ready for the new music that you helping them working on soon, later this year, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So right now, we're going to get into playing some of these new tracks that you got. I got Tears. Tell me a brief story behind this track here, Tears.
Tears is depth. I mean, this is my brand of worship music. To be able to express myself with such depth perception, and being able just to open up and just share how I feel about God being in my life and how he's made changes in my life, and the healing for my soul and my mindset, everything. You know, everything about him is so right. And so I wanted to use words, and you'll hear this in the song, I wanted to use words that really define what I'm feeling right now. And so Tears, you know, I can't hold them back. You know, when I think about his goodness in my life, and, I don't mind dropping a few tears in there, tears of joy and happiness, you know, that he's in my life. It is, and so basically that's why I had to describe it in this song.
Yes, and I love this song because when you have tears and praying to God, he sees that you're giving him your whole soul and death in your heart, and you pouring out your heart. And that's the realest relationship that he sees through your heart. And that's why I love this track, Tears. You're just be so on point. And I'm like, wow, he done did it again. So here it is. Here it is. Tears by Lee Alston, everyone.
I'm so grateful, I feel so
That is so deep. Wow.
Thank you.
So, will you be doing any online events, Lee?
As a matter of fact, I found me some information today that I'm gonna have somebody help me do some of these virtual concerts and
yeah.
whatnot like that. So that's my next move. I'm gonna take these songs and compile them on a video. And so that way people can see actually what I'm doing when, you know, as I'm singing the song, and you can just vibe in that, you know, vibe in that when that comes out. And so that's probably the next project I'm working on for myself, is to get this streaming so people can actually see me and what I'm doing
yeah.
right out here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm working on projects as well where people can see me do my radio shows.
Oh, okay.
I won't be doing
okay.
as much of them because it takes a lot of time and effort, and it
yeah,
kind of yeah. kind of get too much in my way, because I have so many mm-hmm. artists that wants to come on my show. So
mm-hmm.
yeah, I'm working on that as well. But will you go ahead and mention your website information and your social media pages so people can
okay.
follow up?
Yes, you can go to my main website, which is https://alignaga GullahSoulMuzikLee.com/F